Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is your neighborhood friendly Oxhorn, and here we are with another efficiency settlement build, this time of the Egret Tours Marina. This is one of my favorite settlements. It used to be my player home for a long time before I made some changes to it. Let's hop into the sky and I'll give you the overview of what it looks like. So here we go. It started as a marina with basically a marina tour. They would have boats out on the water and then go on a little boat tour ride out along the river, and this was the main tour office here, and it looks like I've got the roof glitch yet again. I'll get him down. Anyway, so this was the tour office right here. This was a boat dock. This was a workshop or something, and then this was like a little diner where people could buy food and stuff, and it's a cool little settlement with lots of potential. You could do a whole lot of things with this, and I had a lot of fun putting it together. So let me show you exactly what I did. Starting out here in the parking lot, let me just show you the way this is laid out. So the road comes in from the north down here, and then it ends. That road just ends right here, and then there's this parking lot area. I decided to put a guard tower here to greet people as they come in, and then there's a guard tower over here, because there are some attack spawn points over there, and I'll explain that in a little bit. But then, in a little bit. But then I was left with what to do with all this space. And I figured that since this settlement was large enough, I would turn it into a large bar. So I've got all of these different bars, 17 different bars total. And the reason I have that specific number is because if you've watched my happiness experiment videos, you'll know that I created a happiness calculator, a settlement happiness calculator, and based on my calculations for a settlement of this size, I need 17 bars in order to reach 100 happiness. Now, I'm not there quite yet, because during the construction of this settlement, I had things like loss of power, loss of defense, and it brought my happiness down. But I have 35 people, plenty of food and water, plenty of defense, plenty of beds, and my happiness is steadily rising. I'll show you what my target happiness is in a little bit. So because bars produce the most happiness of any other unit, each bar produces 40 happiness. And the way the calculation works is you have to divide each happiness by your total number of settlers before you'll understand the total amount of bonus that you're getting. Because each bar generates 40 happiness, I needed 17 total to get to 100 happiness with a 36 settler settlement. Moving on into here, I really liked this sort of crumbling walkway between these two buildings. It reminded me of like a little European gallery, a little European village or something, especially with this building, which has this nice brickwork over here on the sides. And so I decided I wanted to do a little something like that. Now, I used to have my shops lining the walls over here, and I decided to go against that because, as you can see, an enemy spawn point is right here in the middle of this settlement. And this is why, ladies and gentlemen, building walls around your settlement, it's rarely a good idea because, number one, enemies can teleport through walls. Number two, Bethesda puts spawn points in the very middle of some settlements, meaning that unless you use a mod that tells you where spawn points are, like the mod I'm using, you can never predict where they come from. Sometimes they'll come from non-intuitive locations. And that's why I don't build huge walls with my settlements. Instead, I try to overwhelm the enemy with the shock of the initial attack. And so let me show you briefly the defenses. So I've got this station right there looking directly at this spawn point. And on this station, I've got a missile turret, two heavy laser turrets, and a spotlight, providing plenty of defense. And then the other spawn point is over in this corner. You see that? It's right up this hill. So there are only two spawn points, one over there and one over here. So I've got a nice tower right here to defend the settlement with one missile turret, two heavy laser turrets, and a ballistic, and then two heavy ballistic machine gun turrets and a spotlight. And so that gives me defense to obliterate anything that spawns here. And then I also have another guard tower here. Now, one thing you might not know if you haven't used the settlement before is that even though what I'm about to show you is not an enemy spawn point, where enemies spawn to attack the settlement, it is a place where enemies spawn quite frequently. So over here by the bridge, enemies will spawn right here by these sleeping bags. Sometimes they're raiders, sometimes they're rust devils if you have automatron installed, sometimes they're aggressive scavengers, and if a settler kind of wanders too close or if a provisioner walks by, they'll attack, which could kind of bleed over into your settlement over there. By the way, let me show you this. If you come up into this bus, ready to get freaked out. Whoa! What is that? It's the hugest teddy bear I've ever seen. Now, I'm a little bit confused about this, and I'm genuinely getting creeped out by this thing. Look at that. Ah! I remember when I started playing this game that this was an oversized teddy bear sitting in this seat with the postman hat on. And look, you can even see the postman hat. Well, it was embedded inside the teddy bear. I think I just messed it up. But the teddy bear used to be facing that way. But I don't know. I came up here for the first time in a long time, and I turned the corner, and there he was looking directly at me. And he looks a lot bigger than he was. So Bethesda has a history of having items strewn throughout the world. Some of them are smaller than usual. Some of them are larger than usual. If you want an oversized stuffed teddy bear, that's where you get it. Anyway, so what you may want to do is you may want to have some defenses over here. Even though there's no enemy spawn point over here, enemies do spawn over by that bridge, and they can come over here. I've found, actually, that if you line this roof right here with missile turrets and heavy laser turrets, they have very long reach, and when the enemies spawn, these will attack automatically, and you can kill them before they even have a chance to aggro with you. But I didn't put any here because I wanted to save on resources, so instead I built this really tall guard station, and he'll alert my settlement if anything spawns over there. So that's my defense, and that freed me up to keep this little alleyway here between these two buildings as sort of like an outside eating slash lounge area. So I have some tables over here filled with noodles and vim. I've got just some loungy chairs over here with some drinks and cigarettes and lighters. And then I've got some garden gnomes from Far Harbor. I have a new mod installed. It's called OC Decorator Far Harbor, and it's basically an update to the OC Decorator mod, but it supports all of the new stuff that comes with Far Harbor. There's a gnome over here. There's some eating stations over here. I've got a lounge over here with some cigars and cigarette machine, and then I tucked this Nuka-Cola machine into this little crevice right there. I also saw that there was this display window over here, and I wanted something clever to do with it, so I used this clothing stand from Eleonora's Crafting Fury 9000 GTX. It's quite a name. And this is the Minuteman General's outfit, of course, and so I stacked it right there, and hiding behind him is a mischievous gnome. So I thought that was fun decorating that little thing right there. Man, they just are all over the roof today. There we go. Stop climbing on the roof, lady. All right, let's go into this primary structure here. As you can see from the outside, I repaired the walls. So I used the wall tiles from the Far Harbor barn set. These construction tiles only come with Far Harbor. And this entire corner was blasted away. And so I fixed it with those particular tiles. Coming on into the inside, and this floor right here is my kitchen area. You need to really be quiet, Nick. You talk over me with every video I do. You need to calm down. So I decided to place a sink over here. This is actually a scavenging station that's been reskinned to look like a sink. And a settler who's assigned to it will come by and actually perform the designated animation, which in this case is washing dishes. I've got some kitchen utensils up there. This deck right here, this little bar area, I just filled with a random assortment of doodads and plates and kitchen utensils. It's an oddly positioned area, what with this falling floor piece, which you can't scrap, and I was a little bummed about that because this just gets in the way. I wanted to patch the floor, and I did patch the floor, but I couldn't get rid of this broken floor piece because you can't actually select it. So it stuck there, and I decided to just put this filled refrigerator tucked in behind there, and you can see that it's filled with all sorts of goodies. And many of the paintings on the wall are actually original. Like this one right there came with it. and it's tilted and it's beautiful, and so I left it. I think that one came with it as well. Tilted, beautiful, so I left it. And then here's the eating area. I decorated these with all sorts of foods, including Vim and Mirelurk omelets and Mirelurk queen cakes. That's a cooked fried fog crawler right there. Oh, I'm sure it's appetizing. Vim on the tables and art on the walls. And then there's a big pile of produce right over there. Because this is an oddly proportioned downstairs area, I had to put the working kitchen stove over in this corner. And it's okay. I don't think it's that big a deal. Moving on upstairs, and this is the parlor area. This is the lounge room. This is the game room where people can come to relax. I've got sort of like a glamour portrait theme going on here. Lots of glamour portraits on the wall. I've got a working television over in this corner.
The new Band-Aid plastic strip with new super stick.
And it's going to be really loud and it's going to be distracting, so I'm just going to remove the holotape for now. But it's a working television, and this guy's got a pint glass with a beer over here, and this guy's got a beer with a smoking station over here. Now, this pink floor tile, which you only see when I enter workshop mode, is a relaxation point, and this comes with the build your own pool mod, which also comes with working showers. And what's interesting about this is you can put these relaxation points down anywhere you want, and settlers will be attracted to those areas at the end of the day, just like they're attracted to bars at the end of the day. In this way, you can kind of help guide your settlers to the points of interest around your settlement, instead of them always just going to the bars. So, as you can see, it disappears when you exit the workshop mode, so most people won't even see it. And in this way, I'm able to make sure that settlers come up here to watch television, to shoot pool, to play checkers with bottle caps, to play blast radius, and to just hang out in this nice loungy area at the end of the workday. This little platform right here, which I assume used to be a guard station or something, I just turned it into a nice loungy cigar area, so you can come out here with your cigar, just look out the sights, take a look at the beauty of the marina. You know, every single companion that you bring to this settlement, and any settlement near water, complains about the smell. They're like, oh, it smells like water. Oh, it's sewage. It's got a sewage smell. And man, does that get annoying. And I also don't understand it, because if you're by the seaside, if you're by the water, you would think that one of the cleanest places in a post-apocalypse would be a place with a lot of water, because at least it's going to be washing away. All right, now let me talk about the boathouse. This is the boathouse, and I did a lot of work to this to make it a dormitory. This is where all of the settlers live. The first thing I did is I patched this boat area. So if you come down here, you can see that there's a boat ramp, which is designed to launch boats, and I actually used the console to generate this rowboat so that I could have a nice little rowboat here, and I pushed it down there. But what I did is I covered it up. I patched this boat ramp, this boat launch area, with floor tiles, and then I put these carpets down on top of it so that I would have a place to put more beds. This is one of the primary sleeping areas of the settlement, and I have plenty of dressers with nice vases everywhere and pictures. They can store all their clothing so that they actually have a place for personal effects. And then each night table, which is beside each of these beds, is decorated in a unique way to kind of show off the individuality of that particular settler. They've got their soft drinks, they've got their cameras, they've got their own personal effects that are important to them. I used my precise movement and rotation tool to fix this door. So this door came with the settlement, and it was hunched over and pushed into a corner, and I sadly couldn't remove this huge pile of garbage. So that's a bit of a bummer. But I was able to fix this door, so at least I'm happy about that. And then over here was just a huge gaping hole. You can see the original door frame is just this huge gaping hole. And what I did is I built the barn doors. You see where the red wood is? That's the barn door wall. And inside that, I placed these large barn doors that are working, so that the settlers can open and close this area just like they used to be. The original barn doors are right here. You can see them, right? and ideally you would slide them back and forth, but it's non-functioning, so I built my own barn door that is functioning. This particular boathouse came with all of these, just many of these shelving units. There's one right there, there's one back there, there are a bunch up here, and you can't scrap them, you can't interact with them, they're just taking up a lot of space. Look at them all back here. There are two back here. Did I knock something over? I could have sworn I heard something fall. Oh, that's right, it's the chain. Now that's an interesting thing about this settlement. There are free-hanging wires and chains that you can actually interact with, see? There. And it's swinging more. It's bumping into my light bulb. It's funny that they would program that in. It's actually bumping into my light bulb. Anyway, so there were just all of these shelving units out here that I've just got overwhelmed. I mean, I can't decorate them all. There's only so much that a dormitory will need. So over here in this corner, I decorated it with pillows and sheets and towels, lots of things that settlers are going to need in their own living quarters. I've got a dresser over here decorated with a globe and some flowers. And then each settler has a unique bed with a uniquely designed nightstand so that it shows off a little bit of their own unique personality. And it's sort of like an upstairs loft. In order to get this to work, I had to repair this wall. The original loft ended right here. There was a tiny, tiny walkway along this wall, but all of this was open. Like, I would be falling through right now if I hadn't repaired it. So I used these sort of loft grate tiles that came with Far Harbor to patch this up so that I could use it as a place to store beds, to place settlers who are sleeping. But even then, that was not enough, ladies and gentlemen. So coming out here, I patched this up here so that this is a nice walkway. And then down here, this is the primary dock. There are three docks, 1, 2, 3. This is the primary dock. And you see a lot of settler activity over here because there's actually settler beds and a lot of eating stations. So out here on the dock, I thought it would be a nice loungy area. I've got these tables out here with beer and vim and lights and smokes and plenty of seating. And then this little shack came with the settlement and it was barren on the inside. There was nothing there, but I figured, why not turn this into a little restaurant? You know, I'm sure the original tours had a snack shop or something. In fact, this was probably it. And you come in here and it looks like a diner. So I decorated some of the cubby holes with food. I placed some drinks up on the counters. By the way, I love the attention to detail that Bethesda puts into this. Look at this bottle of wine. No, this bottle of wine. You know how it says Amontillado by P. Edgar? That's a reference to a short story by Edgar Allan Poe called The Cask of Amontillado. And the reason they included it in the game, I explored that in my last settlement build, The Castle. The reason that they included it in the game is because the original Fort Independence had a legend dealing with a soldier being bricked up inside one of the walls, inside the vault of the castle. Edgar Allan Poe heard that story, and that was his inspiration for his short story, The Cask of Amontillado. So when they used Fort Independence as the castle, they of course read up on Edgar Allan Poe and his short story, and they decided to incorporate that into the game, and that's why we see these bottles of Amontillado wine by P. Edgar, which is Edgar Poe. I just thought that was a nice touch by Bethesda. It's really cool. Anyway, so I used this really small bar and I used my precise movement and rotation mod to push it in here. And I'm just so glad that it actually works. Yes, it clips. It's not perfect. I just got to deal with the cards that Bethesda has dealt me. And she still cleans the top here and she still works as a functioning merchant. And she's back here and there's no clipping issues. She walks back here perfectly. I have this decorated with Deezer's lemonade, Gwinnett ale, some vim, another big cask of drinks, lots of cups, more soft drinks over here, purified water, Institute water, Ware's brew, all sorts of goodies, and then a line of pint glasses so that when customers come towards the end of the day, she's ready for them. So I had a lot of fun decorating this with OC Decorator. But I thought that, you know what, this is quite a lot of real estate for just this tiny little diner. So what can I do with this? I needed more beds anyway, so I built this shack on top of this diner. Now first, let me show you what my settlement used to be like. Remember I told you that I used this as my player home? The way I used to play this game is I would just go into a settlement if I thought it looked interesting, and then I would just throw something down like a stream of consciousness, you know, Picasso, right? It didn't follow any rules of logic. It just hovered in the air, but it was large enough for my needs and it had everything that I needed, and so I didn't care. When I started doing my efficiency settlement build, I, of course, started to care about the aesthetic of the settlement. And so now that I'm here at the Egret Tours Marina, I tore down that old structure and I built this new structure on top of it that actually makes sense. It has a pillar on each corner that's buried deep down into the water. And there's a ladder that goes up that the settlers will actually use. It's a functioning ladder. So coming on up into the first floor, and this is the remaining beds. A bed for each settler, each one decorated with that settler's own unique, interesting doodads. And then going on up, we find a shower facility. These are functioning showers. Settlers will use them and the player can use them. And as you can see, I've got those pink mats down to act as hotspots so that at the end of the day, the settlers will come on by, take a nice hot shower, use the sinks. These are all workstations. You can actually craft things with the sinks. And so the settlers will use them. And as they're using them, they can look in their mirrors and so on and so forth. So this is my community shower area, complete with soap on the wall, towels on the wall, towels stacked over in the corner. And then I walled off this section of it to create as private of a bathroom as I could. I've got some towels and bathrobes and stuff over there, decorations on the wall, and then a toilet in these stalls that's as private as it can be, with toilet paper on the wall and everything. Now, after building it, you know, I'm thinking of the logic to it, and having a shower facility above where people are sleeping when your floor is made of wood doesn't really work, does it? You know, but I can only work with what I've got, and I was running out of room, so this is where I decided to put it. Hopefully there will be no leaks leaking down onto these poor settlers sleeping here. Okay, so that's my little shack. Now let's talk about the workshop over here. This is an original workshop that came with it. By the way, there was a rowboat stuck up in the rafters there by the chains, and I sadly had to scrap it in order to build my loft up there. That's why I used console commands to generate that rowboat down there and place it there using my precise movement and rotation tool. But in this little shack, this is the workshop, and it comes with this rowboat here, and I just liked it, and so I left it there. I decorated this corner over here with a lot of industrial looking stuff. These come from Far Harbor. This, I believe, is like a fog condenser catcher or something, I don't know. Cans of paint, engines, compressors, all sorts of machinery. This is my fusion generator. I've got a workstation over here. This is from a mod that gives me the standing terminal from Automatron cut away that I can use just as a regular terminal. And then the electricity is piped out here and then across the water to feed my water purifier right there, which is right here where the boats are, and then right over to that house so that it can have electricity. And then over in this corner, yeah, here's another one. Here's just a hanging fluorescent light. It does work, and you can interact with it. You can bump into it. You can't actually break it. It's just funny that they would put something like this there. You can't scrap it or anything. So over here I've got a tool bench and a nice shelf with a whole bunch of workshop doodads. And there you go. That is my workshop. Then on this dock over here, the third and final dock, I wanted to have another shack. So I decorated with a bunch of crates and fishing nets and stuff over here. And then I built this shack to act as a laundry facility. So coming on in here, I've got a laundry machine. Oh, and it's the wrong way around, and I'm just now realizing that. All right, bear with me. Here we go. There we go. Now it's the right way around. So I've got a laundry station out here with complete with a working washer and dryer. I've got some boxes up there. Here are some nice shelving units, complete with lots of clean folded clothes that I'm sure has just been laundered over there. Doodads and cleaning utensils over here. A nice shelf with chemicals and cleaning powders over there. And then a nice working sink with a laundry bin over here. So this is the laundry shack on this dock. Then over here, I've actually got a fish catching station. That's right, it is right by the water. It is a marina. So I figure they can pull the rowboat out of that shack over there every now and then, go out and catch some fish, come back here, and then they can grill the fish up on this little grill right there. There's a nice bag, a big basket of caught fish right there. Fish drying out on the rack as well as a Marler catchling, and then a big burning barrel for them to warm themselves with. Just a lot of nice clutter to make it look used. And then up here I've got the Brahmin, because I absolutely hate the Brahmin. So I've got them as far away from me as possible. And no matter what I can do, I can't seem to place these troughs anywhere that doesn't result in the Brahmin hovering. I mean, unless you're at a perfectly flat spot, the Brahmin are just gonna hover in the air, and I couldn't find anything that I could use. So anyway, I've got a trough filled with water and a trough filled with feed so that the Brahmin at least can have food and water. And then over here is my farm. So this settlement came with this nice rusting fence, and I thought, well, that's a perfect place to place food. Now, this farm I put down before I came up with my own way of doing things. I put this down before I started using carrots as the primary crop for most of my settlements, and it already had enough food, and I figured, you know what, why remove it? So I've got an orchard of mute fruit plants over on the far wall against this building, and it is surrounded by this fence so that, you know, it kind of feels contained and apart from the remainder of the settlement. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is the long and short of it. This is my Egret Tours Marina. A lot of fun to put together. Look at all my dogs. One of the things that I realized with my happiness experiment is that in order to get that last percentage point that pushes me into 100 happiness, I needed 10 dogs. And so I've got 10 dogs. And that reminds me, I'll go ahead and show you what my target happiness is so that you can see what this setup is going to net me once enough time has gone by. So we're going to go ahead and load our settlement management software. And then I'm going to go into the view statistics to see the happiness target. And you see that my happiness target is at 100. That means that I've already done everything necessary to get to 100 happiness. Even though my happiness is currently only at 82%, it will eventually reach 100 happiness once a few days of in-game time go by. So that was the goal with this. You have a much easier time getting a settlement to 100 happiness if you have very few settlers. But if you do have a lot of settlers and you do want your settlements to look large and lived in and functional, like they're living, breathing things, then you're just going to have to get a lot of bars. There's just really no other way around it. So there you go. This is my little bar marketplace, which generates happiness for my settlement. And this is the end result. Let me show you what this place looks like at night. Here you go. This is the settlement at night. As you can see, it lights up like a diamond. You can see it from far away. I've got lights over here by the marketplace, and so it's well lit with these lamp posts. This building right here is lit up well. You can see all of the little windows have light coming in and out of them. The inside has lamps and working TVs and lights on the wall. There are lights inside each of these lamps works. They're wired with electricity so that each of the settlers will have some illumination at night if they want to read or whatever. And then you can see the light peering through the cracks of this little shack that I put together. I've got a nice warm amber glow down here where we've got some lanterns and some candles. And then on the inside, you've got this brightly lit sleeping space with completely lit showers on the inside. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is my Egret Tours Marina. Thank you so much for watching. I'm almost done. I've got the Mechanist Lair and Spectacle Island left. That's it. And that's every single settlement in the game done. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to be working hard on those to get them to you. Please subscribe for more Fallout 4 and Far Harbor content. And thank you all so much for watching.